So hello again, this is Carlos once again, talking to you on my Wednesday show as I wait to cross Cordova Bay Road and head to the trails on the other side. Let me just put the camera away. My video is over for today. The rest of the show will be audio only. All right, this isn't an official crossing spot, so I have to wait. Now I'm safe. I might have missed the 2 kilometer announcement, but the plan is to take you from the 2 to the 5 along this trail. It's basically the Whitaker Trail all the way to Glendenning, and then I carry on to Beau Park, over the highway, over Mackenzie Avenue, I should say, and on to Fairways Market, where I'm planning to buy another can, a beer brewing can. Hopefully it's on special this week. There goes the 39 bus. I'm going to have so much on my back coming home that I'm going to take the bus home. So that's why I'm saying I'm recording. I'm recording now so that I can get my shopping done and go home and then upload the show. Zone 3, I heard that clearly. And I also heard 11 minutes per kilometer, which is faster than I intended for today, but what the heck? What the heck? That's what I say. I'm going to be skirting the edge of the road, but safely removed by a big clump of bushes. Wild wasteland. The gates are closed for the park, so anybody here has to park and then walk up. There's no driving until noon, by which time I will be home. There is some music going on, but with the traffic noise, you're not going to hear much of it until I get on to Glendenning. Okay. I don't think we're missing much. I have downloaded an offline playlist from YouTube Music. It's one of the few monthly subscriptions that I have, and I really do make the most of it. Now everything you want to listen to is available for streaming or downloading. If it's on YouTube, you can listen to it offline. I think I'm paying less than $20 a month for my subscription to YouTube Music. And depending on how much space you have on your phone, you can download hours and hours of offline listening. There's not really too much point, as once you're home, you can listen to it online, streaming. That's the beauty of it. You don't have to keep it you can have it available. It's like a free, unlimited jukebox. I'm going to slow down a little bit just so that I can enjoy the recovery process. My ankle is getting stronger again from walking. I'm not really sure what I'm listening to here. I think it might have just ended. Whatever it was. As you can imagine, I'm having a lot of fun with the early summer here in the forest. This sounds like Steely Dan to me. I think what it did was, based on my preferences, it chose 20 songs to download as my offline playlist. So that's what we're listening to. Its selection of what it thinks I like. It's not often wrong. Sometimes it was, like with that penultimate song there. Not sure what it was, but it's coming off. When I get back home, I'm taking that one off. I might bump into Jackie today. She often brings Zephyr to Glendenning for his daily constitutional. Yep, I think I got the sound balance just about right today. I do have my good camera with me, so you will have to remind me to take some pictures before we get too far out of the forest. So I'm just crossing the base of the power line trail, heading now towards Glendenning. Some hikers up there. It's a big male chocolate lab. Hello, dog. Dog without an owner. Oh, there we go. Is that your dog?
Yes, that's
me. Okay. Good. Seen him before. Give me a big hello friend smile. I kind of like these mashup shows. It's a chance for me to allow some other input other than nature and my voice. So I haven't really noticed a jump, too much of a jump, in my listenership since I'm now available on Spotify. I think the 16 people that listen to me on a regular basis have figured out how they're going to do that. I'm just looking for a few more who might like using Spotify as their podcatching platform. Give this one a little bit of room. Hello.
Thanks.
Yeah. I would have lost out if we'd collided. He was definitely bigger than me. His mass would have overpowered mine. up we go. This is where I broke my Achilles tendon. Right there. Sorry about that, it's just a habit of mine. If I fall, I spit where I fell to remind myself to be more careful. Now this band, Steely Dan, were huge in England. I don't know if you knew this, but they were huge in England when I was an impressionable 20-year-old. But I can't honestly tell you one single name of one single performer on this album. None of them, not even their faces, I wouldn't recognize. Hi! I recognize her. That was Chris. She did the one, the Fuca Trail, once. She joined at the beginning and did the whole thing by herself. And she had a couple of bear sightings to deal with. Yep, I keep bumping into active friends of mine running while I'm walking. I guess they don't recognize me, partly because I'm walking and partly because I'm wearing my visors, my eye protectors. Our friend Ron in Georgia has had cataract surgery as well. So there's another surgical survivor. There's McCann, there's Ronnie and his eyes, there's me and my eye. Okay, this I believe is called Equinox by John Coltrane, played by 10 seconds ahead. Okay, I can handle that. I'll let you listen to the music for a while now that it's going to be a little more pleasant as the ambient sound of my neighborhood dies away. Somebody is pressure washing, I believe. I haven't been able to hear an announcement for 10 minutes now. So, I've done one with you. That's about 12 minutes of audio recording. Yeah, I've recorded from 2 to 3. And I'm going to take you through to 5. And hopefully I would have just about finished my walk then. I should be on Garnet, just next to the library. But because I'm recording with the old Sony, I have to get my laptop involved. I'm going to need to make a quality decision very soon about whether I should use my Sony or just switch to doing it all with the phone again. I can always do editing afterwards, but it's just the convenience of having the phone handy for audio recording. It's linked directly to Spreaker. So, it's no big deal. I'm going to need my laptop. I'm not trying to not use a laptop anymore, but I'm trying to cut down on my screen time. And one way that I did what I did when I left France was I deleted the Facebook app from my phone, and suddenly I got 4 gigabytes of space returned to me. Good morning. It's a guy double polling there. Had a nice, you know, those ginger coloured French poodle. Standard, tall, not a toy poodle, a big size poodle with poodly hair. Anyway, Glendenning, here we come. And then I'm officially out of the park. And then I'll be on laneways into another park. And then I go over a footbridge and then walk past an elementary school. I believe that's how it goes. If I'm walking at 12 minutes a kilometer, so it should take me 3 to 5 if I started at 2. 3 kilometers at 12, 36, which is arbitrarily my optimum length of show. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4 cars parked here. Space for 8. Space for 7, actually. Yep. Here comes another car. This one will have a choice. The next one, not so much. I'm taking the bridle trail because there's a guy walking on the road towards me, and there's also a car behind him. Good morning. A gas-driven car, how about that? They will be a novelty soon. A curiosity in the next decade will be the gas-driven car will still be around. Today is recycle day on my street. How many times have you heard me say that? I always record on Wednesday, so it often overlaps with recycle day. I think there was more than a minute and 5 seconds ahead. I should slow down a little bit. Now we've got some aviation around. It's definitely something in the sky. A plane. Not a helicopter, they make a lot more noise. Helicopters must be one of the most inefficient forms of transport out there. The guy I used to know was a helicopter pilot. In fact, I've known 2 helicopter pilots, and they both loved flying, and they both referred to the regular airplane as a fixed-wing aircraft, because if you think about the lift from a rotor, it's to do with the airfoil of the blade. It generates lift like a wing but the wing is moving through the air rather than the air moving over the wing. So to overcome gravity, all that force has to be generated by a spinning wing. Hence the inefficiency. For getting from A to B, it's terrible. It takes off and lands quickly, but it uses a lot of power to accomplish that. Alright, now that I'm getting closer to Mackenzie Avenue, I'm beginning to realize how much more time I have to fill. So I will take a little break from talking, unless something exciting happens. You will hear music and me breathing. Mount Douglas Crossroad. I'm going to take a picture of Christmas Hill from here, just because I know that I'm 3 minutes ahead of the game. The guy stopped his car so I could take my photograph. Isn't that nice? There is another scenic spot a little further up. Once I cross Mackenzie, I will take some more photographs then. A bit of construction going on here. They're putting in some new houses, some big million-dollar houses. Yeah, there's about four new houses. smell the smell of warm sawdust. It's amazing how noisy a neighborhood is. Even a quiet neighborhood is noisy. That's what I like about Jim's show. He's got a good quality microphone. In fact, a good quality stereo system for microphones. And he has a very quiet neighborhood. That is when the birds sound so clear. You can almost see them in the sky. Unfortunately, you can't really get that with the trusty Sony. It's a mono, single channel recording, or twin recording. I think that's what it is. Two identical channels. So this is Van Morrison, Van the Man. I'm guessing I'm probably up to about 4 kilometers. But I once again see this Triumph Thruxton. I'm going to take another picture of it. It does look rather splendid, I must admit. It's one of those retro-looking designs. It's probably a restored original. But now Triumph probably has a restored to original kit that you can buy. All you need is the engine and the frame, and the rest you can buy as add-ons. So today, instead of going up the Beaupark Hill, I'm going to be going across towards the footbridge over Mackenzie. After this tune, I'm going to pause it briefly to see how the recording is going in terms of time. This is once again an album that I probably never had with Van Morrison music, that I probably predated. I have just missed hearing it in the past, but I'm hearing it now. Alright, so I'm going to pause and have a quick look. Okie dokie. Alright, so I have 29 minutes recorded, so I have another 7 minutes, basically. I should be okay with this. Morning. Hello. Some more active neighbors walking their dogs. Hi. Zone 2. Once again, I'm in the park. Just at the foot of the Beaupark ramp. Which reminds me, I still haven't sent anything to Kevin for 182. Maybe I'll mention it. 182 coming up for Kevin. And I think Martha's up to 17, and Bruce is into his second decade, I think. Hi. That guy is a city worker raking the undergrowth. There's probably some lawnmower guys here today clearing the brush. This is the time of year when they do it. Reduce on possible fire damage. All this fuel, as they call it, is what they're trying to remove. All last year's garbage. All the dead branches and twigs from last year and leaves that haven't decomposed yet. That's what they're doing. They're cleaning the weeds. Alright, so not too much excitement now. It's just going to be the highway and the footbridge. And then I'm going to be beside the elementary school. And they might be on recess, so you might hear the screaming kids. We'll see. Well, it's field day. Kids are running around the track. I love it when they bring out the paint and mark up the track in the backfield. I guess all schools do that, the ones that have fields. I guess I take that for granted. Maybe a lot of inner city schools don't have fields. So to do a field day, they would have to go somewhere. All right, Mackenzie Avenue is the noise now. Yep, well, I think today's title is going to be Suburban Mash. Suburban Mash. That should give everybody a heads up on what to expect in terms of suburban music and suburban noises. Mackenzie Footbridge is one of the noisiest places in Victoria, especially around this time, I guess 9 o'clock-ish. So the kids have all been called to a meeting. Somebody is telling them what's going to happen. And very soon they're going to be let loose as groups of runners. Yeah. They're sorting out the girls and the boys. Nope, it's not quite that simple. I see a baton. That's what they're doing. They're doing a relay. Well, let's take some organizing. I'm going to take a picture of the relay. Thank you. in a second when I get onto the quiet. There they go, the first lap, the first half a lap, and then the transition happens. Good transfer, good handoff, or whatever they say. Yep, it's a close race. It's a close race. And there's going to be another handoff here. There we go. Well, that's fun. I'm glad you didn't miss that. So I just heard the 5 kilometers and I just checked, and sure enough, I'm on 36 minutes. So I will leave you listening to a little bit of Sade as I head towards Fairways and my eventual destination. Bye-bye.